Hi, this is Bill for Sparky Channel, and today I'd like to show you how to bend EMT and how to incorporate a number of different bends in one run. We'll start off with what we call a box offset bend, which raises the EMT 3/8 inch off of the wall to smoothly meet the fitting on the box. Then, because we encounter an obstacle, we will make what we call a three-point saddle bend to smoothly jump over the obstacle, which is a piece of 2-inch ABS pipe. Then we'll make the first of two 90-degree bends. When we have two back-to-back 90-degree bends, we call this bend back-to-back 90s. However, before I make the second 90-degree bend, I'm going to cut the conduit to length and put on the second box offset bend using the concept of gain. Otherwise, the conduit would be very short and I wouldn't have leverage to make the box offset bend after making the second 90-degree bend. Then finally, I'll make the last 90-degree bend, which will complete the back-to-back 90s. First, we'll start with the first box offset. I'll make one mark on the conduit at about 2 inches in. That's an arbitrary amount. It could be 2.5, it could be 3 inches, but I made mine at 2 inches. And then you make the next mark in 2.25 inches from that. Now look on the back of this Klein tape measure. You can see the multiple for the 10 degree bends that I'm going to make is 6. And we're rising up off the wall by 3/8 of an inch. So 3/8 times 6 equals 2.25. So that's how you get the distance between those two bends. There are a lot of people just eyeball it. I'll make the first 10 degree bend on the first line, spin the conduit around 180 degrees, and then I'll make another 10 degree bend on the second line. Now for the 3-point saddle bend, the distance from the fitting on the box to the middle of the pipe, which is our obstruction, is 24 inches. Because our obstruction is 2.5 inches and we want to clear it by 1/2 inch. So we want to rise up 3 inches off the wall. The 3-point saddle bend is going to be 22.5 degrees, 45 degrees, and 22.5 degrees. So if we look at the back of our Klein tape measure, we see that the shrinkage is 3/16 of an inch per inch of height of obstruction. So that'd be 9/16 of an inch. So my first mark on the conduit for the 3-point saddle bend is at 24 9/16, the 9/16 inch being for the shrinkage. And then to each side, I'm going to make marks as well at 7.5 inches plus and minus from that center point. That's because the outer marks are 2.5 inches per inch of height of obstruction with the 22.5, 45, 22.5 3-point saddle bend. I'll start the 3-point saddle bend by putting my middle line on the notch. I'll brace the handle with my boot and I'll bend the EMT conduit to 45 degrees as marked on the bender head. Then I'll spin the EMT 180 degrees and I will put one of the outside marks on the arrow of the bender this time, with the hook of the bender facing the middle of the 3-point saddle bend. Then I'll bend it to 22.5 degrees as marked on the bender head. Normally I would do this third bend of the 3-bend saddle in the air, but because of the really long length of pipe in front of me and the very short length of pipe behind me, I decided to do it on the ground. And notice the hook of the bender is facing the middle bend of the 3-bend saddle. And I'm going to be bending this one to 22.5 degrees. Notice I actually have the conduit suspended in the air in the back and I press it down. Boom, there it is, 22.5 degrees. And that's right on the money, 3-bend saddle. So now we have a box offset and a 3-bend saddle and they're all on the same plane. We'll need to make our first bend at 44 inches. That'll be a right angle bend. And here it says stubs 5 inches to arrow. You're gonna need to know that. Okay, there's our 44 inches right there. And you subtract off 5 inches and there's a 39. So that's where we're going to be putting the arrow of the bender right there on 39 inches. With the arrow of the bender on 39 inches and the handle perpendicular, I'll go ahead and bend the conduit to 90 degrees. It's a good idea to check your bend and make sure it's right on 90 degrees. One way to find gain for your bender is take a piece of EMT and cut it at 40 inches and put a nice 90 degree bend on it. Then add the distance from here to here. Okay, and from here to here. Add that together and then subtract off 40 inches and you'll have your gain. The gain for my half inch bender is 2 5/8 inches. You see, this pipe gained length when it was going around the corner because it didn't have to go all the way to this edge and so forth. So we say that gained some length. So I'm going to use this calculation in determining where to cut my pipe. So we have 29 3/4 rise from the 90 degree bend, and then we're going across 12 inches, and then I'm going to subtract off my 2 5/8 inch gain, and so I'll be cutting the pipe at 39 1/8 inches. Now I'll bend on the box offset for this end of the conduit, making sure that everything is in the same plane. See, I have the 3-point saddle bend in the right plane. Have everything in the right plane there. Checking it out. And here goes the first 10 degree bend. Now I'll spin the conduit around 180 degrees, put the bender arrow on the second mark, and I'll go ahead and bend the second part of this box offset. I have dry fit the conduit before making the final 90 degree bend. I can make the final 90 here with the star on the bender, or I can go 5 inches below that and use the arrow and make the final bend. I'll choose to use the star. Okay, so we're gonna put the star right on the line. Okay, and we get my bender and this part of the conduit in the same plane. Now we're gonna go 90 degrees. Okay, so this is a back-to-back 90. Make sure these are going straight. Okay, so now you're in a situation you get into a lot of times with a back-to-back 90. If you're doing this right, this is going to be hitting this pipe right here. So I'm going to go like that. And now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go to the side a little bit. All right, that feels like 90. Perfect, right on the money, that's perfect. Okay, so here's our back-to-back 90s with a box offset, a 3-point saddle bend, and another box offset. Let's put it up. Okay, that goes in there. Okay, here's the run, and this is a box offset right here. We got a 1-hole strap, and right here we have a 3-point saddle bend, and I got the middle notch almost exactly in the middle of the pipe. And then over here, we can see that we are level. This is showing level right here. And there's another 1-hole strap. And here's our first 90. And this shows that we are plumb. You see, this is level and this is plumb. And then here's a 1-hole strap, another 1-hole strap right here. And we go to another box offset. And there's the box. So there you go. Level, plumb, pretty darn accurate, and all one piece of conduit.
I'll put links in my video description for all the tools you saw in the video. Thanks. I hope this video was helpful.